present day, what do you put down to the mini slump? What do you reckon teams have found us out? Do you think it's a mixture of main men being out, the flash, the copies?
Yeah, I mean, the injuries obviously disrupt you.
Because a small squad, aren't we?
Yeah, we are, but we're a very good squad, and I believe in everybody in that squad, and I believe that everyone will do a job. I mean, every team, you know, they have a bit of a patch, I think, in the year. Like, say, when injuries hit and things like that, and to stop the fluidity of the team. We've had a few different combinations and stuff, but you know, we've got quality all over, and I'm sure we'll be absolutely fine. We're not worried. Mm. We're annoyed that we go out there to win every game. So to be on this bit of a dodgy patch, it's frustrating for everybody involved. You know, not just the fans and the coach staff, those players, because you know we pride ourselves and especially what we've achieved so far, but you know, it's nothing unless we keep pushing on.
Mm. Did you go Friday? Was you there Friday?
Yeah, I was there Friday. It was you know, difficult conditions. I thought Lee played well. They defended very well. But you know, we know it wasn't good enough.
Yeah. And it was in the tackle. They did a good job on it, to be fair, Dukes, didn't he? And the coaching staff.
They did play well. But you know, we can be better, obviously, and we will be better.
Where was you today when did you listen to it on that we'd got fourth or?
Yeah, I was just chilling at home. I just kept checking Twitter. I've got a friend who's a diehard Wakey fan, and I was with him on Saturday, and he went to the game saying he's going to be finished top four. He said he's a top four club, but I didn't really say anything to him, though, because
we deserve to be in the top four, really, don't we? I think, yeah, you know, fair play to them as well.
Yeah, they've had a good year.
They've had a good year, haven't they? But it's good to see the likes of Cass up there and us and Wakey, isn't it? To say we're going to finish above Wigan, Saints.
Yeah, prove a few people wrong, haven't we? Yeah. I mean, at the start of the year when they're all predicting us to finish bottom or, you know, that bottom area, I definitely didn't think we would be there just from the quality we had and from what I'd seen in training. And just, I was really surprised. I didn't really know what to expect, but when you see everybody and how good they are every day, you just really start to believe in something.
How do you rate Watto as a coach?
Yeah, he's good, isn't he? He's a real good bloke. He's brought me on a lot, and I can't.
He's had a lot of faith in you, hasn't he?
He has, exactly. That's what I mean. I can't thank him enough for, you know, it's can't have been easy. I suppose he could have brought someone who's, you know, a bigger name, and he took a chance on me. And I'm injured right now, but you know, he's.
I mean, did you read the reviews of yourself when you, like, last year you were this and you were coming to Super League and you thought, shit, am I that really good of a player? Or do you really think, I am, do you believe in yourself type thing?
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't really know. Yeah, I do. I suppose you do. It's nice when you've got people around you, you know, you could encourage you and things like that. But you just, obviously, you know, you must have done okay to get here. So you've just got to keep trying and keep improving and keep learning.
Yeah. It must be really hard being injured, knowing biggest game. I mean, I've been a fan for 40-odd years now. And it's the biggest. This is the biggest. I mean, we got beat by Sheffield a few years back. I cried that day. We were there that day and got beat. Yeah. We go into this game as underdogs, really, don't we?
I was gutted when I first.
What is it actually gone?
It's something like one of the ligaments in my legs.
Did you know as soon as you thought?
Well, I did about a minute into the second half. Sorry, I did a run and I landed on it a bit funny, and I thought, oh, that's a bit dodgy. And I played for about another 10 minutes, and then I was just like, you know, I'm struggling. So I just felt like I was being a bit of a burden. But I think we had Logan who was. Fresh or I think it was long at the time. I can't remember. So it's just one of them things. But I was gutted. All I could think about as well at the time was thinking, oh, we've got, you know, some big games coming up. We've finished top four. We've got the semi final, and then obviously the final when we get there. So.
So will you be involved this week? Will Watto involve you? Will you stay involved?
Yeah, I've been outside today, done some bit of running and stuff like that. But I'm not in full training, obviously. But
how's Manu looking?
I've not really seen much of him, but he seems like a real good bloke character. Yeah,
it was funny watching him the other night because they don't sing in Australia. The fans don't sing.
Yeah, I actually had this conversation with him. Like I said,
and he was like bowing. He was like,
yeah, well, it's just he said, yeah, they just kind of they cheer when you score and things like that. And obviously, boo when you're not doing so well. But yeah, it's just a different culture, isn't it? Like, our fans over here, you know, sort of the class out there, so.
I mean, there's not many of us. We should be getting 10,000 there, shouldn't we? But we're certainly
though,
vocal, don't we?
We're certainly
vocal. We are that. So are you here for the breakfast on Sunday? And then there's a big breakfast Sunday, you know? All the fans have been invited.
Is it? Yeah. Suppose how much I know.
Yeah. Of course, you're 10 alive for breakfast, but.
What are you getting with it?
Yeah. We're Witherspoons, we're making a full day of it.
Witherspoons. You can't
be a spoons, can you? No, you can't be a spoons breakfast, can you? Witherspoons on the train, so we're going. So we're going to move on to your next piece, won't we? It's a bit of punk rock, American punk rock.
Yeah, they are. They've gone back quite.
The Bouncing Souls.
Yep.
Where are they from there?
My old brother's got me into kind of. I mean, my dad likes a bit of punk, like Sex Pistols, things like that, but yeah, my brother's got me into these and. One of the first bands I ever went to watch, and I've seen them quite a few times, and yeah, it's good.
Do they play over here, do they?
Yeah, they're coming tour over here. They're pretty big in like kind of the punk.
This'll test Williams out when he edits this out to try and find these. So we're going on the Bouncy Souls and True Believers. I met some people along the way. Some of them been, some of them stay. Some of them want, some more gone by. Gotta be friends, I love till I die. Come on, these people are trying to. Some of them shine, some of them burn. Some of them rise, some of them fall. But good or bad, I love them all. Bouncing Souls. That's them too. Do you model your game on anybody in particular? I look at you and rate you. I mean, you don't play, but rate you in the same mould as Darryl Clark. Would that be fair?
I don't know. He's somewhere else. He's a very good player. I suppose in terms of kind of running game, I would like to, you know, be as good as him. You know, he's a very good runner of the ball and just a all round decent player, so
I think he was a better player at Cast.
I don't know, maybe he was just a bit different. I mean, everyone knows what he's about now.
But
I don't know, I honestly couldn't tell you if he was better. I suppose he did have a very good year. But he's still doing things that he's been doing back then. It's, you know, like James Robey, I think it's just kind of he does it that much pretty much every week consistently. Everyone just kind of take it for granted.
He's been a great pro, hasn't he?
James, another player who's he's been awesome for, you know, like I say, consistently for the last how many 10 years or something. So,
and do you see yourself here at Salford long term?
As long as I love me, yeah.
You enjoy it here.
Yeah, I enjoy it here. Yeah,
you're living over this out of the dark side and living on the proper side of the Pennines now.
Yeah, I've had to move over, haven't I?
Have you?
Yeah, I'm just living in Walkden at the moment, not too far away.
Right.
Yeah.
Getting plenty of Domino's pizzas and things.
Maybe after a game, man.
And you're a big Leeds United fan, aren't you?
Yeah, I like Leeds United, yeah.
Yeah. Do you watch them? Do you follow them?
I used to go when I was younger with one of my best mates. I used to go quite a bit when I was about 15,
14, 16. And you're not quite a Manchester United fan, are you?
Nah, not one of them.
Yeah,
I won't say that about them, though.
yeah, especially Dennis Robbins Riley, you can't slag his team off. He'll come after you. So how many years have you got to run on the contract?
I've got till next year, so I signed a 2-year initially. So, yep.
And hopefully he'll, as fans, we hope we'll extend.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
And obviously your goal maybe to play for Great Britain if they come back to...
Well, I suppose I haven't really thought about that too much. I just want to get back playing
So we was just before we finished, we was coming to a couple of your tweets that we found.
Yeah.
And this one's from 2013 with Daniel Mark Taylor.
Right.
Yeah. And it was a tweet that said, I was laying in bed at 3 p.m. this afternoon talking to Kris on the phone discussing how many hearts we had broken last night. So is that from uni
days? That was uni, yeah, but he didn't even go. He was about 25, 26, one of my brother's age, but he used to come through now and again for a night out, and he liked to think he was a bit of a ladies' man.
So you don't find yourself a bit of a ladies' man, have you?
Nah, I've got a girlfriend.
But the funniest tweet that I found was from 2012. And it said, just had a dream that my mum didn't cook us a Christmas dinner.
Is that from me? Well, it would have been awful, wouldn't it? I don't even remember putting it. I've had a conversation before. Imagine waking up and not having one. It'd be horrible, wouldn't it? It's the best bit of Christmas.
Really?
Well, yeah.
So I work Christmas, so it doesn't really bother me. So do you want to have a look at some of your tweets, mate? Because they're absolutely fantastic, mate.
I say I don't tweet much. So
No, I gathered. I only messaged you 2 months ago, and you've only just seen it.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, no, it's okay, mate. So we're coming to your last piece of music, Kris. We went to see the Four Tops, didn't we? You didn't get invited. We went to see the Four Tops and the Temptations.
Good.
Yeah, it could be the same band, really, couldn't they?
Similar.
The Four Tops, Tavares was on first, right? Then the Four Tops came on, and then the Temptations. But near the end of the concert, one of the Temptations fell off the stage. Bang! Down he went, 12 foot. Down he went. And I said to Harris, I said, I wonder if they could borrow one of the Four Tops just to finish the gig off.
Yeah, they've got a similar sound, haven't they?
But they were good. So this is a bit of Loco in Acapulco. Is this your, where's this? What's this, one of your party pieces? It's going back to the 70s.
Yeah, I suppose. I used to, again, it was kind of like a winning song. When I was at York, used to put it on as well. We used to dance around the changing room to old school tunes.
This is his heartbreaker song.
Yeah. This is what you serenade your girlfriend with.
Yeah, exactly. That's it.
So it's been good to meet you, Kris. Let's hope you get fit and back for the eights.
Yep.
We want to get in that top four, don't we?
Yeah, most definitely.
Wembley first, and then we'll get to Old Trafford.
That's the one.
So it's been a pleasure to meet
you,
mate.
Thank you very much. Cheers, man.